Hey everybody, this is Mark from Northwest Bourbon. Thank you for joining me. Tonight, I'm going to get into a blind flight from LiveWire Whiskey. If you don't know Adam and Mike over at LiveWire, go ahead, jump over there, give them a look-see. Now, they sent me a blind flight, so I have absolutely no idea what I'm getting into here. They sent me four different bottles. It's just A, B, C, and D, so I don't have to take off my boots or anything. It's not rocket surgery. And I've got a key right here that's in a sealed envelope. Adam emailed it to me. I just forwarded it to my wife. I didn't even open it. She printed it off. She sealed it in an envelope and it's sitting right there, and it's going to sit there until I'm done trying all these. Now on my sheet here, I'm going to be ranking them on which one I like the most to which one I like the least. And I'm also going to, you know, write down some notes on the palate and the nose, of course, but I'm also going to do my best at guessing the proof and what bottle it is, like at least what distillery or somewhere close. And I'll probably just jack that all up. What I like to do when I get into a blind flight is I like to have a warm-up drink. Something to just kind of acclimate my palate to say, hey, wake up guy, it's bourbon time. And so today I started off with some Knob Creek 9. It's 100 proof. I think you should start off with something that's not finished, something you're familiar with, something between 90 and 100 proof, and something that's not too distinct flavor profile wise. That way it just gives you a good starting point, like a reference to go from and to just get your mouth ready. So I've already labeled the bottom of these Glens A, B, C, and D so I don't mess them up. And I'm gonna fast forward pouring these bad boys and we'll get started. All right, so I'm gonna do my best here and see if I can figure out what's in glass A. It's nice and sweet, candies and flowers. It smells delicious. That's nose glass B. This one's much darker. It almost has a finished smell to it, like there's a hint of wine barrel in there, but I'm not sure. And it's got some grapes and figs. Let's get on glass C. This one smells like it has a little bit more proof than the other two, but it's not necessarily really high proof. It's got some light caramel, almost like a Werther's Original. All right, on to the nose of glass D. Ooh, that has a different smell to it. There's a little bit more like almost a cocoa and caramel. All right, first smell I was getting more candy, like cocoa and caramel, like Rolos and stuff like that. Then the second smell I'm getting much lighter fruits, almost a bubblegum. It's weird how the nose just shifted like that. Now it smells like Four Roses. I don't know, D's got a really interesting nose. I like it. All right, I'm putting next to the nose on D if it's a blend, because it had so many different things going on. Went from chocolates and caramel to bubblegum to that Four Roses distinct smell. Like it's kind of all over the place. And so I'm putting a question mark next to if that one is a blend. I'm probably gonna look like an idiot and that's like regular Buffalo Trace or something. Into the palate on A. Cheers. A lot more citrus than I was expecting. It's got a much higher proof than the nose led on. With the drying and the tingling I'm getting in the back of my mouth, I'm going to put this closer to 115. A lot more citrus, a lot more floral, a lot more complicated than the nose led on. I'm gonna guess this is a higher proof rye, maybe a store pick or something. It's really good. It's got a great balance to it. All those complex flavors are nice and rounded out. There's nothing too sharp or crazy going on, but it's got a nice high proof. It's got a nice mouth coat, but lots of citrus and rye spices. That was good. I would definitely drink more of that. All right, let's get on to glass two. Number B. Let's get on to number B. This is one that I question marked if it was finished because I got a lot of dark grapes in the nose. Oh yeah. It's hitting me like a wine finished. It's much darker than A. It's warm. It coats your mouth with a thicker oil coat, like it's tucking you in for bed. I mean, it is very rich and creamy with its warm coating viscosity. That's a real word I checked. The flavor just hangs around your mouth for a really long time. Lots of, like, you know, the black cherries, not like Rainier cherries or Bing cherries or those bright red tart cherries, but the really dark, almost purple cherries. I'm getting that on the finish and the aftertaste. It's pretty good. All right, so on B, I put that on the palate, it was wine with caramel. It was weird, but there was the aftertaste of those really dark cherries. And I'm guessing the proof at 100 and finished in wine barrels. I have not even a stab in the dark at the distillery, though. All right, let's move on to the palate number C. Oh, goodness. Oh, that's a proofy bugger right there. That's got some proof in the pudding. Felt the tingle from the tip of my tongue all the way back. This is more like 125, 130. There's like a dark roasted nut that they left in there for too long. Almost like a burnt walnut. Like they were making a holiday spice cake and they slightly burnt the edges of it. So you get lots of barrel char. This had to have sat in a barrel for a while. So I'm guessing it's got some age to it. High in proof, high in age. It's got really dark, rich flavors. Lots going on. This reminds me of something that I've had, though. It does. It reminds me of something that I had. I wouldn't be surprised if this was from a distillery that I was familiar with. Man, that's a proofy bugger, though. I tell you what. That'll kick you in the pants, even if you're not wearing any. Okay, so for glass C, I put proof at 130. That is the highest proof so far. Burnt nuts, charred holiday spice cake on the palate. I questioned if it was a Jack Daniel's Coy Hill or one of those other special reserves that come out. And I haven't had any of those aside from the single barrel proof, which those ones come off way sweeter, lots more maple syrup and pancakes and stuff than this one did. This one was burnt spice cake. And I have no idea what that is. It was good though. It had really complex flavor that was really interesting. All right, let's get on to glass D. This was the complex one. So on the nose, I said this one went from chocolate to caramel to candy to bubblegum to like a Four Roses flavor. On the palate, it's pleasant. It's soft, it's sweet. It's got lots of fruit notes. I don't know if my tongue is still just really dry from B and C, but it had a little bit of a good drying effect. So I'd put this one at 105. That one is really good. I really like this one. It's really complex. I don't know which way it's coming from a lot of the times. This is a really interesting drink because it hits me a different way every time I take a sip of it, which is just reinforcing my thought it might be a blend. Good. I'm gonna put that one at 105. There was a lot going on in that glass and I really liked it. So I'd rank that one number one because it was an experience and I really enjoyed just nosing it and drinking it, and it being that complex was a lot of fun. All right, so I ranked D as number one, because if I was going to buy a bottle of one of these four right now, as long as it's not out of my price range, I'd want to buy a bottle of D, because it's an experience. It's a lot of fun to drink. Now, after that, I'm going to rank the other three by which one I would be most likely to buy if all three of them were the exact same price. Now, if all three of them were the exact same price, I would go C, then A, then B. So I have bottle A as my third choice, bottle B as my fourth, bottle C as my second, and bottle D as my first. Just a really quick reminder of my guesses. I guess that bottle A was a rye, probably a single barrel pick, around 117 proof, and that was my third choice. I guess that bottle B was around 100 proof, finished in wine barrels, no idea where it came from, and it was my fourth choice. Bottle C is over 130 proof. It's a Jack Daniel's special or something that I've never tried before, and that's my second choice. And for my first choice, I guessed it was either a Four Roses limited edition or something that I have no idea what it is, and that's my first choice, around 105 proof. I really like that one. Really complex and crazy. All right, so let's get into these results. All right, and remember, if you're not already subscribed, subscribe to the channel. Every one of our videos is different because there's a lot of things we do here at Northwest Bourbon that you'll probably like. All right, so let's see these results. All right, for the results, bottle A was Wilderness Trail Rye Store Pick, 103 proof, 4 year, 5 month. And so I had that it was a rye barrel pick. I had 117 proof, this was 103. So I was 14 proof points off on that, which I'm not proud of, but the fact that it was a store pick and a rye, I'm all right with that. All right, next one is B, Wheeler's Raid Rye. I've never had them before. It says toasted, so that's why I was getting those interesting notes. It was finished somehow. I put wine, but I wasn't getting a lot of toasted, like how I get off of 1910 or the Elijah Craig toasted. This Wheeler's Raid Rye, oh, because it's a rye. All the other toasteds that I've tried were bourbons. That's maybe where I got this craziness from. I put down 100 proof. This says 113 MGP. All right, so C, Jack Daniel's Barrel Proof Rye, 133 proof. And I put down that it was a Jack Daniel's 130 plus, but I wasn't sure what type. And so it was a barrel proof rye. All right, 133.4. That was pretty good. All right, the bottle D was my favorite. Peerless Single Barrel Rye, 109.5 proof. I put 105, so I was only 4.5 points away. I said a crazy blend. I think Peerless is a craft distillery, right? And so they're doing their own stuff. And so that's why it was a new experience for me. That's awesome. I've never had anything from Peerless before. Hey, LiveWire Whiskey, thank you very much. This was a really fun blind. Like I said before, if you don't know LiveWire Whiskey, go ahead and go check them out. Thanks for joining me for this blind flight. I'm going to be doing another blind flight next week, so be sure to tune in. Remember, earn, protect, enjoy. Cheers.